Welcome back, everybody. So let's talk about the Raps. What we got in the front, the ball, the Raptors. Will this season be a new start for us? And that first game that just happened, what did you think about it, Mark and Mark?
I think they couldn't play any better than they did. Everything went through the way they wanted to, in terms of defensively and offensively, with Lowry getting everyone involved, Kawhi doing his thing, and Kawhi looked comfortable. That's probably one of the things I took the most from it. And everybody else contributed. I mean, DeLon wasn't there, but I mean the bench mob. It was a good kind of shakeup in terms of the lineup. I mean, it's going to, like Lickner said, he's going to switch it up depending on the matchup. But for sure, we have Lowry and Kawhi. And Danny Green was just phenomenal. I mean, from both ends of the floor, and he just couldn't miss. Mm-hmm. It was really nice.
Friends,
to see.
Kawhi and Danny Green, what do you think about them as players, I guess? Because they're with the Raps now, so.
Yeah, you know what? Amazing acquisition. Sorry, DeMar, but hey, I like the trade, to be honest. We needed a change, right? Yeah. I mean, we weren't getting results in the playoffs. Like, sure, we love DeMar, but we had to make some changes.
Yeah.
But if it's up to me, I would have traded Lowry instead of DeMar.
Ooh. I thought of that at first. I looked at the way they play together, like, I'm okay with that trade, actually, anytime, any day. Like, I mean, Lowry is perfect fit for Kawhi, because of the way he plays defensively, both ends of the floor. Lowry does the same thing as well. I know he's small, but he's feisty. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, you were in the game, so your experience of
So I was at the tailgate party, which it was really cold. So it was the perfect day to introduce Kawhi to We the North. It was extremely cold, but people still went out to the tailgate party, like to the Jurassic Park. I got a free T-shirt. Well, I should have brought it, but the vibe was amazing. Kawhi. I know I saw your Instagram story where he was talking to the press, and you're like, he can talk.
He's not a robot.
But I think he'll enjoy Toronto. It's just everyone's so excited that he's here. Danny Green definitely enjoys Toronto.
Yeah, he's a joker.
He smiles as soon as he heard the crowd like cheer, and he was starting too, right? Mm-hmm. As soon as they heard, you could see his smile just light up. Mm-hmm. And he tried to take a quick shot in the beginning and he missed it. But like, again, like you said, he's fire. Our bench is extremely deep. Mm-hmm. Like, it's crazy.
So good, man.
And they didn't even have DeLon right that game.
They didn't even
play Greg Monroe.
Right?
Yeah.
So I think everyone's excited that Kawhi is there. And it's just, again, another challenge this Friday, right? Mm-hmm. Against the Celtics.
It's going to be a really good game, guys.
It's going to be a crazy game. But so far, I think Lowry's the veteran there. And I think he's going to meld them really well. Because even early on the game, he was trying to get Kawhi going. Like, he had easy shots for himself, but he wanted Kawhi to score. He wanted Danny Green to score, because he knew, like, once those guys got going, everyone else would have been, like, clicking. And what's his name? Siakam?
Like, oh, my God. Like, he's most improved player. He's a candidate already. Yeah. He's a candidate for most improved player of the year already, just because of how he had worked a lot in his game this offseason. You can tell. I mean, he stayed on Love the whole game. Struggled on the floor. And offensively, like, he got the best of, I think, Kevin Love the whole game.
Yeah.
It's also Ibaka. He kind of struggled, but, I mean, he found his way. He found where he was effective at. He was blocking every shot that you can find. I mean, Fred VanVleet was fun to watch. I mean, he couldn't miss. JV was doing his thing. There's a lot of things that they could beat you with, and it's dangerous to have a team like that.
Yeah. Are you coming? Oh, by the way, let's plug that too. There's a Raptors game for a Filipino.
Speaking of that,
are you gonna go?
I'd love to go.
Night?
Yeah. When is that?
Well, I'm not buying you tickets though.
I'm gonna get home, but I'd love to go.
Filipino Heritage Night. Is it Heritage? Did they call it Heritage 26, Night?
26. Yeah. Filipino Heritage Night.
October 26th. There's I think there's still tickets available, but it's against Dallas.
Okay.
So you were just talking about Luka Doncic.
Yeah. Yeah.
So it's a good game. Dallas versus Raptors. It's gonna you get to see a nice rookie, and you get to see Kawhi. Just watching Kawhi. Mm-hmm. I know. I was at a bar, and people were just like still surprised. Like, we actually have Kawhi.
I know.
Like, it doesn't set in.
Back of myself, like, I can't believe we've actually gotten a player in Kawhi's level.
That caliber, like, it's crazy.
I've never seen, like, he's almost the second, third best team, player in the league. We've never had that.
Yeah.
Like, even with in Carter days, like, he's probably at most top 10, Carter, on his prime.
This guy's top five.
Yeah, and this guy's top three. I would say top five, in a sense. Yeah. Like, both two-way player, we've never had that. It's just like, sometimes you just look back when you're watching the game, like, you shiver. I'm like, oh, God.
Good job,
like,
Masai. Good
Kawhi.
Job. Yeah, like, everyone in the bar was just, like, in awe. Like, Kawhi actually wearing a Raptors uniform.
Just because the way he plays, it's very different from other superstar. If you watch his game, it's very simple. He doesn't over-dribble. He kind of makes the play quick. And he knows where his shot's going to be. And he knows what shots he can make. You've seen it. Like, his dreams pull up. Or a turnaround, or that kind of where he just drives into the lane and just kind of off balance, kind of see how he can make it. Mm-hmm. And you'll see him. He's going to play both ends. It's really good. It's fun to watch.
Congrats to Nick Nurse, too.
Yeah. Like, on the first win. Yeah.
First win. Yeah. First and to game. Have that, well, to have that caliber of a player, too, as the first. It kind of reminds me of, like, the LeBron and Eric Spoelstra situation when Eric Spoelstra was brought in. Mm-hmm. And he had to coach LeBron. Yeah. Same thing. Kawhi's like a crazy player to coach, like, to have him on your team. And Nick Nurse, I don't know anything about Nick Nurse, but, like, it's starting
just the way he ran it. What do you think of the way he kind of coached him on that day? Like, did you see anything noticeable difference from the way Dwayne Casey coaches them or the way they run the offense?
I don't know. I saw a lot of post action. Mm-hmm. Like, there was a lot of Kawhi posting up. There was a lot of, like, and Kawhi's dirty in the post. He's so efficient. And JV, I liked a lot of post action, and I could see that they're more scrappier on defense. But so I don't think I've watched enough games to see what Nick Nurse's offense is like. But what do you think? I think you're the analytical one. So
I just like the way they shot a lot of threes. If you notice that the game is still in that predicated on the getting the three ball, and it helps when they have a lot of guys that can make it. Lowry didn't barely miss the shot. Danny Green barely missed a three-pointer. Van Fleet was making three-pointers and Ibaka. So it helps that they have those kind of players that have the ability to make it. And they have a player like Kawhi who's willing to find him quickly, right? And that's kind of the noticeable difference between his game and DeMar, whereas DeMar, he would kind of look for his own shot first because he can kind of make the basket anywhere around the mid-range. So he can make any shots that he wants. It's just a matter with Kawhi. He knows where his spot is. And the moment he knows that, oh, that's not my spot, you can see him throwing it and rotating it to the open man. It's just a very different game from them.
All right. Before we end off, what are your hopes for the Raptors, friends?
I would hope for a finals appearance or a championship. That's what I'm expecting.
A championship. Yeah. That's some
really gritty team.
Yeah. Mark, any hopes for the Raptors?
I just hope you guys keep playing well so we can keep talking about you guys throughout the whole season for Pinoy Crossover.
Yeah. My hope for the Raptors, Kawhi, please stay, even though it's
I think cold. Raptors are going to show him so much love.
Yeah.
And Raptors fans are really good at that. They've done the same thing with DeMar. They've done the same thing with Vince when he was here. And I think they're going to do the same thing, but probably even more. I mean, Drake and Justin Bieber, whoever is...
Personal visits.
Justin Trudeau, please do everything you can to make Kawhi stay.
Justin Trudeau. Yeah. Hey, the Raptors logo is a claw. Your nickname's the claw, bro. Stay here, you know? But hey, we're about to end. Friends, any shout-outs you'd like to give to anyone?
Like I always do, shout-out to my mom and my dad, my sister. That's all.
Mark and Mark with the scarf.
Shout out to our fans, guys. Keep subscribing and keep following.
Hey, thank you guys for watching everything. We have full games of the FBNA on Filipino TV, so watch that and share it if you want. And also, if you have any extra scarves, please send it to Mark because he's wearing the same one.
Oh, this is a different one. It's my new scarf.
But other than that, stay balling, everybody.